Good day to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mr. Fae, and here we have my daughter. I know, my daughter looks a bit ugly and very scary, but this is not my fault. I'm sorry about my daughter, but I was trying to raise her to be a good girl, to behave, you know, to be helpful to the society, but she ended up like this. She ended up like a demon. She's very scary, very powerful, very strong. She has a great body. My daughter is awesome. But boys, stay away from my daughter because my daughter is going to kick your butt. This is my daughter build. My daughter! But why my daughter? Here we go. This build is an experimental build. When we say experimental, this is what I mean. When I started this build, I had the idea to try and make a build in which I would be using as many different types of damage as possible. As many as possible. Which means if I could use, for example, 10 different types of damage at the same time, this is what I wanted to do with this build. So, it is an experimental build. I don't know if in Legendary it will be a powerful build and what not, but in Epic I have finished Epic difficulty. I have died 5 times only, and in Epic difficulty this build is very powerful for now. In Legendary I think that at least in the first half of Legendary this build will be very powerful as well. Now of course when it comes to resistances, we have some problems there. Not now in Epic difficulty, only poison is a problem, but in Legendary, yes, we will have some big problems with resistances, but we will see. We will see. Legendary, we will do other things. Here, in Epic, my daughter. My daughter is very powerful and very scary as well. So, what types of damage are we using? First of all, before we go to the types of damage that we are using, let's go and check out the skills. This is a class of a Spellbinder. The Spellbinder class plays with Defense Mastery and Spirit Mastery. So, for Defense Mastery, I went with the classic skills, Battle Awareness, Focus, not very much. I will put more points on this one later. A little bit of Iron Will. This is the rally skill, and especially the Inspiration add-on is very important. And of course, some Defiance as well. Here we have the Butter skill, of course, because we attack with the seed that we hit and kill enemies many times. Red Armor, I will increase the level of the skill later. We have the Shield Charge, which is a main skill for this build as well. It hits enemies, very, very, very nice skill and very powerful. Especially with this Disruption add-on. This one is very powerful when you use this one, because with this one you increase the targets. With this one alone you hit only one target. With this one you can hit up to 5 targets. Now it says 4 target maximum. If we raise the level of the skill even more, it will go up to 5, I think. Or maybe 6. I think it goes up to 5, if I remember correctly. Here we have the Armor Handling, because this is super important when you play with Defense Mastery, and I chose to go with Pulverize as well, because this is one more attack with the shield, an AoE attack, area of effect. It hits 3 targets maximum, at least at level 6. At level, I think if we increase more this level of the skill, we will get to one more target maximum, but I don't remember exactly the numbers. And I started spending some points here. I will not increase this skill very much, but it is good to have at least one or a couple points sometimes for this one to trigger it to give you more survivability. For Spirit Mastery we have Death Ward. This skill is a life savior, especially when you receive damage over time effects from your enemies. This is this skill is the best for damage reflection. Damage over time, not damage reflection. Damage over time on your character. It is an amazing skill. It can save your life, and you should be using it every time that you play with Spirit Mastery. I'm leveling up my Death Silora. Awesome skill, the Ravages of Time, and of course the Necrosis. This skill is super duper trooper frooper brooper. Awesome and mandatory for this build. Here we have the Life Drain. it is a great skill. I use it all the time, 100% of the time. I use it when I fight against bosses. I use it when I fight against undead enemies. I use it when I fight non-undead enemies. I use it when I fight construct devices and whatnot. Even when I fight gods, because with Norse act, we fight against some gods. Of course, we have the casket because this one is a skill that when you use this one, this is a single target skill. You use it on a target, a single target. But with this one, when you use this one on a single target, from the single target, the first target, more life drain projectiles are cast upon other enemies that are very close to the first target, the initial target. So it makes this skill actually, it transforms this skill into an AoE skill. And it is awesome because you gain life from more enemies at the same time, and it helps to survive much better. And of course we have the soul drain. This is a skill that came with Atlantis. It is an awesome skill, vitality damage, energy drain, very nice, and the more damage to ghosts, and also reduction to enemy's health. Yeah, this is a very nice skill. I'm using this one as well. Of course, all of these three skills are going to get maxed out. The same applies to these two. This is already maxed out because this is the super, throoper, duper, frooper, brooper, xooper awesome skill for this build and many other builds as well. I have only one point here. Because actually, if you increase more this skill, the only thing that you get is second duration, which is awesome and important, and of course energy regen. I wanted to be using this one mostly, this is why I have it, and I'm not using this one very often, only when I see the opportunity to use it, let's put it this way. And this one is very good because it is a buff for physical damage, bleeding, elemental vitality damages. It is an awesome buff. You know, with this build we try to stack as many types of damage as possible. So, this buff here buffs all of our types of damage that we deal, because we deal physical damage, bleeding damage, elemental damage, and vitality damage as well. So, this is awesome. And this is going to get maxed out. Maybe I will also max out this one in the future, but I will see. I don't know yet. We will see. Here we have, of course, the Spirit Ward, because it is a skill, an awesome skill against undead enemies. And the Spirit Bane, which again is amazing against undead enemies. And I have only one point so far invested on the Circle of Power. This is very nice. You know, if you can max out the skill, it's very powerful. If you max it out, it helps very much with your bleeding and vitality damages, and also reducing the recharge of your skills and energy cost and your casting speed. For example, this skill is dependent on casting speed, not attacking speed, because it doesn't use your weapons or shields to trigger. It is a spell, it is not a skill. But yeah, so these are the skills for now for this build. Of course, with this setup of skills, I have finished Epic Difficulty, as I said before, and I had only 5 deaths. All of these deaths could have been avoided, I was just not very careful and I died. But it is okay, I don't care, I am not trying to play deathless with this build, this is an experimental build. This is, for the first time ever, I try to make such a build where I will be using as many types of damage as possible. Now, for the items. Well, these are the items that I have finished Epic Difficulty with. Gabbandine. This item will never be replaced. This artifact. Why? First of all, we get the completion bonus, 33 strength, which is awesome. We need it and we got it and we have it. Of course, this is not the reason why I will not replace it, but this helps 100% the build, so yes, it is a good one. The plus 2 to all skills in Rune Master is totally useless, forget about it, but the other 3 stats are totally useful for the build. Minus 25% recharge. We got it because this way we can cast our skills much more frequently, so we need it. 50% weapon-based damage becomes elemental, which means this is our weapon-based damage. The weapon-based damage is a white number 219 to 227 damage. This is what gets converted with the stat. The base weapon damage becomes elemental, nothing else gets converted. Now with this weapon, we deal the physical damage that it comes with the weapon, and we also deal elemental damage because of this stat here, of this conversion, which means that 50% of this physical damage now converts to elemental, and elemental is three types of damage at the same time. It is fire damage, cold damage, and lightning damage as well. So with this item alone here, this item here, we deal already physical damage, fire damage, lightning damage, cold damage, poison damage over time, as we see on this item, vitality decay over time, as we see on this item, attack damage converted to health, which is actually a mechanic that does life leech on enemies. Yeah, all of these different types of damage. Also, attack damage converted to health is a type of damage, but it works a bit differently. So, with this item here, this item here alone, we have all of these different types of damage. How many did we say? Physical 1, poison 2, vitality decay 3, attack damage converted to health 4, fire 5, lightning 6, and cold damage 7. We have already 7 types of damage from these two items on this build. 7 types of damage. This item is the Vatrahos Breastplate. This is a mastery frequent that you fight from frog enemies in Act 4. It is a great mastery frequent item because, as we see, it came with the Mountaineer's prefix, but Vatrahos Breastplate alone, initially, it provides pierce resistance. And we see that now from this item alone, I get 111% pierce resistance, which is awesome. It is totally awesome. And this item is probably, I don't know, I'm not sure, but probably there is a good chance that I will not replace it because of this pierce resistance and of course the other stats. I have attached an Heracles Might relic because it gives more strength and offensive ability. Now, the offensive ability of this build is a problem for now. Okay, for epic difficulty it is not a problem, it is very good, but for legendary I will have some problems, at least after the first half of legendary difficulty. I will need to get my offensive ability up to 600 to 700. 600 is okay for legendary for the most part, to be able to hit your enemies with melee attacks. But if you got to start dealing critical hits as well, and especially all the time, you need to go up to 800, for example, and even more. But it is okay. Here we have the Boots of Phrygia. This item is an awesome item. I have upgraded this item in epic difficulty, and I got this plus 29 armor and the slow resistance. This is now, I don't even remember how they call the prefixes and suffixes of Impetus. I think this is a Stones or Boots of Phrygia of Impetus, something like that. But anyway, it is a great item for this build. It has a recharge reduction for skills, movement speed, many resistances that we need, of course. This is why we have so good resistances now in epic difficulty. One reason is this item. Here we have Impenetrable Armor of the Tinkerer. Tinkerer items drop only on Atlantis. I played epic Atlantis with this character. I had this item on my stats from older characters, and I equip it here. So, now, I have attached two components on this item because it is the Tinkerer's of the Tinkerer suffix, and this Tinkerer suffix allows equipping two components instead of one on green items. And why did I equip? Did I attach the Poseidon's Trident and the Cold Essence? Because with Poseidon's Trident we get electrical burst damage over time, which is our 8th different type of damage. 8th, because as we said before, we get 7 different types of damage from the combination of this weapon with this artifact. And now with this incarnation of Poseidon's Trident we get the 8th, which is electrical burst damage, and we get the 9th, which is frost burst damage from the Cold Essence relic, charm, not relic, charm. So, This is the reason why I wanted to use the Tinkerer item here, Bracelet Tinkerer, because I was going to be using the Poseidon Strident at Cold Essence to get these types of damage. So, 1, 2, 3 items gives us, this combination of these 3 items provides 9 different types of damage for this build. And we are not done yet. Let's continue. Shield. Weightless Shield of the Tinkerer. Now, this shield is very important, first of all, because it is a weightless one. Minus 18% reduction to all requirements. Don't forget, this is a hybrid build. We try to increase as much as possible all of the attributes. These attributes. Strength, intelligence, dexterity. Because we need everything. We need mostly strength to be able to equip very powerful items. Intelligence to be able maybe to equip some items. Like this one, it requires intelligence 441. Dexterity, because it is very important for offensive and defensive abilities, and of course to equip items. Intelligence is very important also for this one. Of the Tinkerer, why? Because I wanted to use on my shield two components as well. One of the components is the Children of Oceanos. But why? The Children of Oceanos relic provides slowed movement retaliation when melee enemies hit you, and energy, so many energy points, which is very good to have, because we need energy points. But I use this one because of the relic bonus. The relic bonus of Oceanos sometimes is these three types of damage that we see here: bleeding damage over time, cold damage, vitality damage. Now, as we said before, we have 9 types of damage from the combination of these 3 items. With this item and these 2 components here, we get the 10th type of damage, which is bleeding damage over time, and the 11th type of damage, which is the flat vitality damage. The cold damage we already get from this one, because of the weapon-based damage becomes elemental. So, how much? 11. 11 types of damage so far. Wait, there is more. The Atlantean Artifice provides some stats. 17% chance of lightning retaliation, star retaliation, and the lightning resistance. The 40% health reduction retaliation is a type of damage. It is a different type of damage. It works only when melee attackers hit you. When they hit you, they receive 40% health reduction retaliation damage, which reduces their health, their current health. Which means, this is our 12th type of damage of this build currently. 12. Is there more? Well, let me see, I don't even remember. Here we have Alki. Alki is a great item. It provides no types of damage, but it gives the very much necessary strength for us to be able to use our items. If I take it off, you can see that we can use nothing, almost nothing. But if we put it on, yeah. Here we are. Resistant Jewel of the Tinkerer. Why a Tinkerer? Because we can attach two components, two relics. The Star of the Evening, which increases our elemental damages at casting speed, and the bonus gives defensive ability. And the Monkey Kicks Trickery, which gives elemental resistance, the bonus gives more armor, which is very important, and we also get reduced resistances to enemies. And the Skill Disruption Protection. And here we have the Amulet. How many types of damage did we talk about? We said that we have already 12 types of damage, different types of damage. Well, with this one here, we get one more type of damage. The 13th one, which is the 25% energy drain. Why? Because this specific stat also deals damage to enemies, which means 50% of lost energy as damage. You drain the energy of your enemies that have energy bars, and 50% of the energy drain deals damage to the enemy. So, it is a different type of damage in this game. And right now we have 13 different types of damage on this build currently. Which is amazing, and I like this number. This number, yeah, I like this number. And we also have, of course, the Star of the Evening, which, again, provides more buffs to elemental damage, more casting speed and defensive ability. This is the same thing as here. And we have the Monkey Kicks trickery, which again reduces resistance of enemies, gives elemental. It is the same thing as this one here. It is only the completion bonus that changes. This one gives 33 dexterity, this one gives 40 armor. Both are very useful, armor and dexterity. So we have some great combinations of items here on this build. Don't forget this one, Crest of Hypnos. I use this one because this is I think the best item in the game for resistances, for intelligence based classes, because it requires a huge amount of intelligence, as we can see. And as a helmet, it is the best if you got resistances. If you lack resistances, this item is one of the best items in the game that provides many, too many resistances. And it also fits the theme of the build, I could say, because different types of damage. If you have so many different types of damage on a build, all of your enemies should be afraid, because, you know, different enemies have different resistances or different types of damage. And now, if you are very powerful on all types of damage, which you are not with this build, but anyway, then maybe all of your enemies are afraid of you. They are scared of you. And with this one, my daughter becomes a very scary, very terrifying enemy to her enemies and my enemies, because my enemies is my daughter's enemies. This is the setup of items and skills. Well, this build currently deals no piercing damage, but maybe this will change in the future, I don't know, we will see. Now, the attribute points. As I said in the beginning, this build is a hybrid build because I'm trying to increase all of the attributes, strength, intelligence, dexterity, and also I would like to increase my health, because this health is not very good for legendary. At least for the second half of legendary, but anyway, even with this health you can go through the whole game if you are careful enough. But the most important thing is this three. I have some other items on my stats for this build for the future, but the reason why I don't use those items currently is mainly because I lack strength. Yes, if I take it off, I cannot use these very super very important items, and this is a problem. So, for now, I'm going with this ring and this setup. In the future, in legendary difficulty, I will probably have some changes in the build. I will play legendary difficulty the whole game. When I will finish legendary difficulty with this build, I will make a build guide update video to let you know what skills and items I'm using in legendary difficulty, or I have been using in legendary difficulty. I will tell you about how hard the game was and whatnot, all of these things, and probably I will record some boss fights of my daughter against some big bosses, so you can see how this build performs against big bosses and if it is a good build. So far, I think this build is very powerful for epic difficulty. It destroys enemies very, very fast, many types of enemies. Okay, some other types of enemies take more time to get killed, for example bosses, but it makes sense. Big bosses are big bosses, they should die as big bosses, not as regular enemies. But for the most part of the game, this build is awesome. Ah, by the way, I don't know why, but I was killing giants in Act 5, the North Act, super very fast. Super duper very fast. Giants in Act 5 are getting wrecked, totally wrecked by this build. Yeah, I guess those giants are not good enough to withstand so many different types of damage at the same time. 13 types of damage stuck on the build. This is an experimental build, everybody, and I love it. I truly love it. I just hope that in legendary it will be a good one. Okay, so this is it. I'll be back very soon with more live streams and more content, much more content. Don't forget also to check my website every now and then to see if there are any news, or even better, follow the website. And when there are news, you will instantly get notified. with your accounts, Google accounts or emails, and we will have much more content of this build coming super very soon as well. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you haven't done that yet. We have too much content coming in the future, and I will see you very soon again.